Hello students, today I will focus on institutional representation of democracy. Do you know about the term institutional? It means the institution is an authority to issue certain guidelines which are assumed to be followed by the people for the well-being of the people itself as well as for the society in which they are dwelling. On to this, our constitution has created some duties and liabilities regardless on the concept of discrimination that every citizen of the country are expected to follow those. One of the major liability has thus initialized by the constitution regarding casting of votes under constitutional right in our democratic system. The power to cast the vote is given equally to their citizen without discrimination on the basis of caste, religion, race, gender, etc. Hence, the government addressed the universal adult franchise for the prosperity of the nation. The democratic country has thus specified the procedure of election. In the election, every people should take part and cast their valuable vote to the candidate who is going to represent the constitutional jurisdiction. Through the election, a democratic government is elected to govern the country. The term election is derived from the Latin word ligare, meaning to choose. India is a huge country, so the election takes place in different times and at different levels, like general election, or you can say the parliamentary election, state election, local election. Concept of general election or the parliamentary election stands for 5 years tenure and at the central government or the central level. Thus, the Lok Sabha election is known as the central level, whereas state election is known as the legislative assembly election. As well, the local elections conduct at the local levels. Parliamentary or the general election on the term of tenure has based on 3 different time periods. When the government completes the full term, general election conducts. When the government does not complete its full term, the midterm elections are held. When any representative dies or resigns from his or her constituency, the by-elections are held only for those constituencies. The Election Commission is the organization which conducts free and fair election in the country. It is a 3-member body headed by Chief Election Commissioner, who is appointed by the President of India and holds all decision-making powers to conduct free and fair election. Even President of India cannot interfere in his or her decision making to conduct the procedures. The Election Commission has the power to register the political parties, their common goals and interests, which help to generate public opinion in the process of choosing candidates. Any candidate having any criminal background can be debarred from contesting of election. This discretionary power is solely be with the Chief Election Commissioner. Now, in the election process, when the political party gets the authorities to contest the election, the candidates take out assemblies and rallies to convey their manifesto and try to motivate the citizen to cast their precious votes in favor of that particular party. These all workouts are governed by the Chief Election Commissioner Office, like canvassing, authorizing political parties to contest elections, election date, declaration for respective constituencies, counting and result declaration, deputing of presiding officers at different poll booths, etc. As we know, in our country, we are having multi-party system due to regional, religional, caste, race, language, and other various diversities. So we are having such type of party system. Some are associated at the national level are called national parties, whereas the parties which are associated at the regional levels are called regional parties. Those regional parties could form their government specific at the regional level, whereas in the form of coalition at the national level. But hence, some of the difficulties arise for the proper governance, as their interests are varied based on the regional thinking. So these parties cannot run the government properly and always remain in crisis to be dissolved before the term. Students, on this context, we are now aware about the importance of institutions which play an important role in proper governing of the country could be secured through their different activities, which are legally and judiciously valid for good governance in a democratic country. Now, students, follow through the exercise and question answers of this chapter.